How are you guys? I'm blessed to make this video because I believe my advices might help a lot of people who are dealing with what we call long COVID. A little about my history. I was randomly hit by something and it put me in the bed twice within 2 weeks with rough body aches. It wasn't that bad like some people experience, but I definitely could feel it. Never lost sense of taste or smell. I thought it's typical flu or influenza and I just gotta lay down and let my body kill it. I live a very healthy lifestyle and usually my immune system can handle those relatively quick. After 2 weeks, I didn't have a body aches anymore, but the brain fog and the fatigue just took it over. Also, I got some weird symptoms like cold feet and hands, chest tightness, heavy heart. I live in a small city, so I went to one of those urgent care and I tested for COVID negative. So I just gotta lay down, I guess, more. Sometimes I was getting better and didn't try to rush things right away. Something was getting me, you know, back over. Decided to go to another doctor to test for COVID again, negative. Did the blood work, was all perfect except high cholesterol, but whatever, it's not the issue. In the past, when I lived in Miami, I had some weird tropical virus that doctors couldn't find. And I just stayed in the bed for 3 weeks and it was gone. Wasn't kind of like good experience, but whatever. So after laying down for another few weeks and having already 6 weeks total, I already got concerned because something is not right. Still, I have that brain fog and weakness. So I started doing a lot of researches online and found a Facebook group called Survivor Corps. And it appears that there is a tons of people like me dealing with the same symptoms for weeks and months. I have read people's stories, posted mine and got multiple responses and feedbacks. I got scared seeing that people staying with the same symptoms for 4, 6, 8 months, even more. Based on all of the responses, I started figuring what is going on. Tried to use logic, common sense, and my past experience with different type of medical issues like broken parts of the body. I had herniated disc, some Miami viruses. I was checking for any useful info online, but really nothing is proven. Contradiction is everywhere. So I came up with a lot of thoughts and my plan, what I'm gonna do. If you still have COVID with heavy symptoms, I don't think my advices are good for you. This video is for everyone who already tested negative and dealing with post-COVID symptoms like brain fog, weakness, blurry mind, blurry vision. We hate it. I don't have a medical degree, so I'm not gonna try to come out too smart and use some medical vernacular. I simply share my thoughts and my strategy that dramatically helped me and literally got me off the bed. Since the doctor's not coming up with any solutions, I have all rights to come up and advise some. So here's my thoughts and what I did. Look, everyone is laying down waiting when immune system gonna kill this post-virus symptoms or whatever we have, and it's not working. So how much more we gonna lay down? The great Dr. Zelenko said immune system works the way that it needs to be challenged to get developed and work. If you sit at home all your life, your immune system just never see any challenges. What he said gave me a push to start thinking some way. I remember when I was breaking parts of my body, like foot and arm and wrist, with all my sports injuries. After it gets healed and cast is taken off, you have the most important time to make this part of your body work because it's basically dead. You gotta warm it up, work it up, gradually exercise it to make it operate the same way it used to. You need to work for that. Your brain knows and remember how to do it, but your body needs to be worked on that. My other thought was, when doctors don't know what to do, who you gonna rely on? It's just you and your body, nobody else, possibly God. My another thought came from the book of Mantak Chia about eyes and vision. I have read it a long time ago, and he was giving a good points in his advices how to improve your eyesight. It was based on what human beings and their eyes used to do naturally, which excluded any electronics, for example. So this virus is not a flu or other simple viruses, it's a different breed. It got into our bodies, made damage and gone. Whoever had preconditions, it made significant or fatal damage. Again, I don't have a medical degree, but I have a theory that something along the way got messed up in our bodies neurologically, and it affected the entire body with our main organs that all connected to each other. Except the brain fog and fatigue, so many people complain they developed heart issues, lungs issues, brain is not working properly. Whoever had some of those issues before, it got worse. So, like I said, when the doctors don't know what to do, you gotta rely on your body. Let's get back to basics and roots. When human beings came to world, they weren't designed to lay down. We were designed to move and survive. Hunt, work, communicate, to deal with other people in the tribe. Even in modern days, after being born, we went through all of the basic human layers to get to the level to become adults. I decided to change my strategy and put my body to operate the way how it used to, and believe it's gonna start repairing itself from inside. I'm not a mechanic, but as an analogy, it's like an engine that needs to work to stay alive. It doesn't really like to stay without work. And if it does that, it gotta then to be warmed up. People after tough injuries and brain damage learn how to walk or talk back again. So I believe that's what we need to do to our bodies. We're gonna go back to basics and put our bodies back to work and to operate. But no sports, don't get me wrong, no sports. So my first day with new approach, I went to the coffee shop, tried to talk to cashiers, some random people. It was so bad and I felt so retarded, but I was able easily to sit and work some hours on laptop. Of course, I couldn't really focus that much because of brain fog. Right after, I went to the park and I couldn't stop walking. It felt so good just to walk. Trees, ocean access, we got some nature. And I would keep walking and walking, but it got cold. So I decided, okay, that's probably enough for the first day after straight up laying down in the bed for 6 weeks. The second day, my heart could feel kinda heavy, but I pushed myself and did some work around the house for the first time. Went to walk in the neighborhood, checking for some properties, met my former worker, talked to him for a while, and I didn't feel retarded talking to him. It was a good day. The third day, I went full mode working around the house. I do home improvements, and for the first time since I got sick, I fixed my mess in the car. So it was almost regular day of mine, just my lungs could feel a little bit tight and I guess, yeah, inflamed or whatever is happening there. My fourth day, I was feeling good and I went to travel to different city. I was making stops, walking, enjoying nature or some nice constructions on the way. So I got myself back on like 90% within 4 days. The fifth day, I had a little roll back to the fog and feeling weird because I spent half of the day in the hotel and another half driving, so I was kind of locked in, and this is not what you do according to my strategy how to recover. Don't get me wrong, I'm not 100%, which would be me doing whatever I want anytime, anywhere, including active sports. And I still can feel once in a while my lungs and heart, which means they need more time and hopefully they will heal. But literally within 4 days, I rolled myself from being tired, laying in the bed in the fog, to full energy mode operation, running daily rants with almost clear mind. I bounced myself back. So this is what you need to do. You already been laying in the bed for how long? 4, 6 weeks, 4, 6 months. It's not helping. You gotta put your body on work. treat your body like it's a child that needs to develop movements and learn everything from the beginning. Your brain remembers how to do things, but for some reason body doesn't respond properly and perform. Something got messed up there and doesn't come across as real. Forget that you used to do some things on some level, because now you need to train and teach your body how to do everything over. And trust your body on ability to repair itself. Just have the body to do what it's supposed to do naturally. Move and work. Here is particular things I'm advising to do. Number one, walk. Walk as much as you want. If you can walk more, walk as much as you can. Simple walk. If you feel a little weakness, push it through. Keep walking. After laying down for months, your brain and body want to trick you that it cannot, but you can. You gotta let your body do the most natural thing it's supposed to do, walk. For those who lived active life, it's gonna be easy. For older people or not active people who used to do just watching TV, laying down, cramps on the stomach, it will be more difficult for you. But eventually you're supposed to increase the time of your walking. If you're getting strong fatigue, go back to the chair or bed. If you don't have any of the fatigue, do not lay down without the reason. Get yourself busy. Go walk. Stay busy. Don't be lazy. Number two, spend time outside as much as possible, especially in the mild cold or cold climates. Somehow there is a huge correlation between oxygen you breathe outside that goes to your lungs and blood and how your body feels. Whatever you do, try to do it outside. Walk outside, of course, get to the park, enjoy the nature, or walk on the streets, enjoy the city movement. You gotta be outside as much as you can. Number three, put yourself back to work. By that I mean whatever you used to do, go do it. In the perfect world, do some work outside, yard work, landscaping, mess with your car. If you are at home, get yourself busy to move. Cooking, organizing closet, but move. Let your body work and do tasks. It's gonna feel weird and you might drop some things, but that's okay. Remember, you're teaching your body to do everything over again. And if you do a lot of online things, this is not good. You gotta do it less. Number four, talk to people. This virus is so weird, it makes us completely isolated. We don't want to see people, we don't want to talk to people, we avoid them. Go opposite way. Try to run little conversations, push yourself, switch little conversations to bigger ones. Ask questions, give yourself boost socially. You're gonna feel retarded first, but over time you will see, you will pick up. Even if you were introvert in your life, I don't wanna hear that. You gotta forget about it and do it way, way later. You were an introvert when you were born as a kid. You were running, playing with other kids, making friends, talking all the time. So you gotta put yourself back to regular ability of human beings to talk. Please try and trust this process. It's not gonna hurt. It helped me to get myself back. For healthy people, it might take fast as me to bounce back. For unhealthy, probably longer. All I'm trying to do is to help everyone who was in the same desperate shoes as me. I believe a lot of people can benefit from taking this path on recovery. Please share this video with everyone who is struggling with long COVID. Comment below if you have any questions, and I'll try to respond to everyone. I'll keep posting on my progress. Also, I'm gonna have a few more videos about getting rid of brain fog, diet and nutrition, and COVID insomnia. And somewhere in the future, I hope to have a video on how to get back to active sports, but there'll be a long way to that. And I gotta test everything on myself first before coming out here and giving advices. Thank you for watching this video. Bye, everyone.